Times of India. I had studied India for more than 20 years before I met Suniti, but but the amount that I learned through her, I wrote a book on Hinduism, Meeting God, Elements of Hindu Devotion, and through the knowledge, the understanding that Suniti gave me, it was night and day difference between my letting go of my misconceptions that had were coming as a an American from a monotheistic tradition into understanding the polytheism and dualism of the Hindu religion. Suniti helped me immeasurably.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yes, it was marvelous. I miss her very much.
I must go back and read that book, Stephen.
Thank you.
We can just look at a few more of her. Now, the interesting is the last woman you have in this book, Swayam. And she's here as a doctor.
She grew up in Kerala, in that state of southwestern India where there's such a high literacy rate, 100% literacy, and the women in her family are matrilineal. So all the possessions come down through her. But she always wanted to be a doctor as a young girl. She married for love, not in a arranged marriage, against her parents' wishes, but she married for love. And her husband wanted to be a filmmaker, came to the United States to be, he was a doctor as well. But he went through medical school, became a doctor, came to the United States to become a filmmaker, but the school that he went to study in went belly up, went bankrupt, and he was forced into trying to find a job to get a green card in the United States. He could come as a student of film. He was accepted. Yeah. But now suddenly, since the school went bankrupt, he's forced in, and they are forced into trying to find their way in their other profession, which is the medical profession, without the green card, without the position. And the story is about their desperation in trying to adapt to a new country and not knowing whether they're going to be able to last. Now, since the story was written, I actually have follow through. After a year and a half of deep struggle, Swayam's husband, Vijay, did get a job as an intern in Chicago. They moved from where they were in New York to Chicago. And Swayam, just 1 month ago, gave birth to their first child, a son, and they are thrilled. So he's in process of getting his green card. It'll be he'll be a doctor. He's being paid as a doctor here in the United States, and things are looking very much up for them.
What happened to his film career?
Well, that's lost for the time being because he couldn't. You know, he couldn't afford not to do it. He couldn't afford to do it.
She did say she sort of failed a couple of exams because they didn't understand her English.
Her English was so poor when she arrived. Actually, her English was good, but her the comprehension of her English, because she was taught in an English medium in South India, but in the Indian accent of South Indian accent of English that was incomprehensible to her examiners.
Steve, I have called to get some help for my computer.
Outsourcing.
And I have to say that I don't understand you. It's my fault. What are you saying?
Right. So Swayam has been working hard since then to improve her American English, and I think now we'll have no problem.
And what a wonderful book. Now, have you done a documentary along with this?
Not about this, no. But I do. We'll have an exhibition of this material at the Fowler Museum at UCLA that opens in late March. I have a current exhibition on at the Mingue International Museum in San Diego in Balboa Park.
Do you show back east?
I give lots of lectures back east, and I have had many exhibitions at museums back east, but there's not one right now. And I did want to say, if you don't mind, that the purpose of this book is not in any way to... I do talk about the problems, the very serious problems of the Indian women today, but I'm also trying to show their strengths. So I don't sweep under in the text, under the carpet, the very serious issues that they have. But I also am trying to show The many ways in which they rise above those mm-hmm. issues individually yeah. to find their own inspirations, mm-hmm. their own strengths.
I forget her name, but there was one who at least had had some education up to maybe the third or fourth grade, who could then work two afternoons a week as a receptionist.
Yes, I think that was Savitri.
Yeah.
And yes, and she was so proud of her children because she could...